So basically it is, I don't know, when you have panties and the elastic has kind of rubbered a bit, you need to only wear it when it has just come out of the wash. Does that make any sense at all? I don't know. But that is, I don't know why that was the analogy, or I don't even know the word. Never mind. Let's just forget that I said that. Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. I'm almost 45 by the way. But yeah, that's let's not go there just yet. Yeah, I have tried fancy intros. I'm not a fancy intro kind of girl. If you like weirdness, if you like makeup, if you like sarcasm, can handle a little bit of ADHD here and there, then just make sure that you have hit the subscribe button because I upload regularly. I love indie makeup and colorful makeup, and I'm also discovering my love for neutral makeup. So yeah, but also if you want to learn how to put on makeup on skin that is a little bit, well, older and a little bit more, let's say, loose in certain places. Hanging is also a word, but yeah, I don't really like that word. So let's say moving, loose moving, a little bit more pliable. I don't know. You get my meaning, right? So yeah, that's what I want to focus on this year. So yeah, and also, I don't know, I like to chat. So let's chat about stuff that I got in December still that I have not really played with yet. Today is January the 2nd that I'm filming this and I'm already rambling. I haven't filmed in about a week and a half. Can you tell? Also, if you hear licking in the background, I swear it's not me. One of the cats is sleeping there. Just so you know. Let's kind of tell you what we are going to play with today. I think I have it in the intro or in the title as well. But yeah, I have received some new goodies from 5050 Makeup. Some I bought, some is PR. That's basically it. I ordered a highlighter and a palette. And then she made a very, very cutesy Christmassy package out of it, so yeah, and she put in some other goodies, so let me just show you what she put in. Let's start with highlighter, because let's start with the highlighter that I ordered, which is the shade called Galactic Purple. Now, I have been eyeing this highlighter ever since, yeah, that's basically it. I've been eyeing this highlighter for a very, very long time, and I don't really know why I never ordered it, but I never did until now. So yeah, then she sent me the shade Blushing Pink, which is a little bit, it kind of reminds me a little bit more of a, yeah, it's Blushing Pink. When I look at it, it's maybe a little bit more peachy almost, but still very, very pretty. And I do really like their highlighting formula. So I'm going to play with one of these today, or maybe even with both. I haven't decided yet. She also sent me, kind of weird, by the way, that I don't feel fancy enough for a fancy intro, but I do feel fancy enough for fancy clips. Does not matter. That's the stuff you're getting here on my channel. So yeah, if you like that, you know what you have to do. But she also sent me some pigments. So let's start with shade number 25, which is a very, very nice bronze. And it is, I thought it was a pressed glitter or a loose glitter at first, because it kind of behaves like a glitter when I swatch it. But it is not that. It's, I think it's just flakes. That's it. I swatched these with a wet brush. However, this particular shade I think works best if you kind of press and, I don't know, almost pat it on. And then you can get a nice shiny surface. And then the next one is shade number 38, which is basically the same, but then in a loose shimmer formula. It's so, so pretty. And then the last shade that she sent me is shade number 47. Am I saying that correctly? 47? Yes. Never mind. We say it actually backwards, or not specifically backwards, but you start with the 40, we start with the 7. So when I say 47 the way that we say it, it's 7 and 40. That's, you learn something. Yes, never mind. But it's very, very pretty white. Yeah, and I think very nice to do frosty looks and also to do inner corner work. She also sent me two of the neon pigments. Now, I already had the shade Magneto, let me show you, which is a purple. I already had that one, that's this one. Very, very pretty. But she also sent me the shade Spicy Orange. Now, in the swatch, it doesn't look that orange. It is, though. The neon doesn't really show up. It's truly, truly neon. And I actually need to, maybe I need to move these So I can, because I also have a mixing medium, maybe I can have fun with basically neon liners, because you can make this into an eyeliner if you use a mixing medium. But yeah, let's go then to the pièce de résistance, the thing that I am very, very excited about to try, and that is the revamped Desert palette. Now, when they launched two eyeshadow palettes. They launched the Desert and the Aphrodite. I have the Aphrodite here. The Desert, I was kind of eyeing, but I was not allowing myself to also like neutrals at that time. And yes, I know what I said, and it is on purpose. But they revamped it, and I hope that she will do it for the Aphrodite palette too, because I'm actually very curious what she will do with that. This one has no pressed glitters. The other, I think the Desert had two, if I'm not mistaken. The Aphrodite had three. Back then, I did not know. I did not really like pressed glitters that much. But yeah. So the outside looks very, very pretty. The palette is cruelty-free. I don't think it's vegan though, because it doesn't say so here. So I'm guessing it's not, but it is cruelty-free. It does contain talc and mica and phenyl trimethicone. And that is the only silicon that I know of. Maybe is silica also one of the silicons? I don't know, but silica is also in here. So yeah, that's a little bit of information about the ingredients. And you get 12 shades. It's a combination of mattes and shimmers. The shimmers swatched beautifully. They are so nice to the touch. And the mattes as well, they feel soft, but not too soft. I don't know. I cannot wait to play with this formula. Let me just say that. And yeah, that's basically it. I have done most of my face already, to kind of save a little bit of time, because I tend to ramble, in case you haven't noticed. I didn't do highlighter and blush yet. Or bronzer. I don't know if I want to do bronzer today. Maybe a tiny bit, but I haven't decided yet. But I don't really know the vibe that I'm going to create. So that is why I haven't chosen bronzer or blush just yet. And I also kind of don't really know what I want to do color wise. That shade Havara, oh, that's so pretty. I kind of want to keep it a little bit simple, but I also, I don't know. Let's start with the shade Havara, because, oh no, let's start with priming the eyeballs, because I haven't yet. Let's get the NYX glitter primer. What's the primer I want to use today? Let's, shall I do the Kiko one? Sure, let's do the Kiko one. I also kind of wanted to be chatty today. So yeah, you get a chatty video of me as well. So yeah, there's that. I'm going to start with the shade called Havara. Oh yeah, and in case you don't know, 5050 Makeup is a Dutch indie brand. And 50% of their proceeds go to a charity that you can pick from when you place an order. And I am also an affiliate with them. Very, very pretty. Oh, I love shades like this. It's such a pretty shade. I'm tapping it on because my base is still tacky. But also, I prefer this style of, well, basically blending. Because I don't have to tug at my eyes as much. I will do a series. I'm going to start a series on my channel that is geared specifically towards working with older skin. Why? Because older skin behaves differently. You know, it's looser. It has more movement, but less elasticity a lot of the time. But I, yeah, I want to focus on that again, because it's just different. You need to work differently when your skin is looser. Yes. By the way, I'm using synthetic brushes, the set from Nabla I'm using. I'm going to go to a slightly smaller brush, but something a little bit more fluffy than the one that I used. I'm going to tap over it, and I'm going to blend very, very lightly, but just the edges. So my goal is to move my skin as little as possible. And I know that I'm moving it by tapping, but I'm not doing that. Does that make sense? But again, a video series about that is coming. I kind of need to think how I want to do that. I also kind of want to use the gray, because I think that will be very pretty. But do I want to use the gray now? Sure, why not? Yeah, that's also something I Sometimes I try to plan my looks. Usually I just fail miserably. It's just the way it is. Or am I going to do the brown first and then the gray? Let's do the gray underneath my eye first so I can kind of see how it behaves on my eyes. I love the combination of gray and yellow, for instance. So I really like the Pantone colors of this year, actually. I also like gray and pink. Now, if I have a light gray, I like it with a soft pink or gray like this. If I have a very deep dark gray, I love it with a hot pink as well. I love it with yellow. I love it with red. It's just, I don't know, I do really like gray. I really like the grayness that it has as well. Maybe I will leave it like this and just focus on deepening up the crease. So let's do that. Let's go to the shade called... Am I going to go to Sonora? Sure, let's go to Sonora first and then I'm probably going to pick this one again. So, what else do I want to do on my channel? Basically, I'm going to deepen this up a little bit higher than the darkest. Oh, this is pretty. This is a very, very nice shade and it goes on top of another eyeshadow. Very, very pretty. Oh. Also, that's also something I could even do a video about that. You know, the fact that I am allowing myself to like neutrals. And that is a specific word choice because it's true. So yeah, maybe I will make a video on that as well. I also want to do more chatty videos. And not specifically just videos where I put on eyeshadow. I just want to, I don't know, when I have a look on, film a little bit more with it. And try to pre-film a little bit more. So I have a little bit more free time. I don't know. Something like that. And usually I fail miserably. But yeah, after this video is done, I'm going to film my December haul. Because yeah, we're in January. And now very lightly I'm going over that border between the two previous shades. I want a little bit of that yellow back. So I'm cleaning the brush, a little bit of the shade Havara. That mustardy, poopy yellow. Okay. Then I'm going to go to a smaller brush. So now I'm going to use the shade called Date. That one. So I have a brush that's a little bit more fluffy, that basically distributes a little bit of a wider range. So that when I tap it on, it is not just placed, but it's also blended a little bit at the same time. So yeah, what I also kind of want to do is, I want to make another clay house. Now I have made fairy houses in the past. Basically, before I did this, I made fairy houses. I'm very creative and I need that creative outlet. And I want to film it as well. I don't know if I will do many of those though. But I think it will be fun to do, I don't know, do something like that every once in a while. Not a lot, but just it's a creative process as well, you know? Yeah, I want to use the gray. Okay. So I'm going to go to the shade called Calcite. This one again. And I'm going to concentrate this very low. What I've also been thinking about is doing another 5 random facts about me. Because I think those videos are fun. I really enjoyed doing more chatty videos in December. But I also want to put on makeup because that is... Yeah, what I also love to do. So I'm going to try and find a balance between that. Gray, yes. Yes, that is what I want as well. Do I want a gray eye pencil or do I want a... I don't even know if I have a mustard yellow eye pencil. Or maybe I want to do something completely different for an eye pencil. I haven't decided yet. So let's hold that off and grab some NYX Glitter Primer. I don't think that the shimmers really need it though. But I want that stickiness because it is better for my eyelids. It stays on better. And I'm just putting a little on the brush. And then coating my eyeball. with it. And again, I'm just tapping it on. I'm trying to be a bit precise, but I'm also tapping and I'm basically just following the shape of my eyeball. Okay, so I'm going to go to the shade called Kavir, that one. And it's going to go on the eyeballs. Ooh. Oh, so pretty. Oh, yes, so pretty. Okie dokie. Then for the bottom, I am going to grab some... Where is my small brush? Why is everything always... Okay, so I have a very small brush and some NYX glitter primer. And I'm going to put glitter primer on my bottom lid. But first I need a pencil because I know the pencil that I want. Yes, I have a pencil here from Catrice. It is an 18 hour color and contour in the shade Absolute Craziness. Yes, okay, then a small brush and some glitter primer, and I'm going to put a glitter primer on my lower lash line, just below the lashes. Okay, then I'm going to go to the shade called Oasis. I really did not know why I loved this type of shade so much. Now I do though, because it's basically the color of our North Sea, especially when it is storming. This is basically the color that it kind of turns to then. When it's just cloudy, it's more of a blue-gray, dark blue-gray. But when it is very storming, this is the color that it kind of turns to. So, or at least the stretch of where I live. Okay, I want that dark shimmer a little bit higher. So I'm grabbing the shade Oasis on the bigger brush. I'm just going to press it here in the outer corner, but still on the lid. And then I have a little bit of that other shade on the other side. I'm just going to tap it over to get it to the mix. That is almost it. Okay, what do I want? Will this be fun to put in the inner corner? I don't know. Or shall I just go for the I think that is going to be fun. Okay, let's grab the Galactic Purple highlighter. Okay, that very tiny brush I'm grabbing again for underneath here. Okay, and this is the eye look so far. Let me just finish it off with liner and lashes and all that before we finish off the rest of the face. Okay, eyes are done and I thought let me put on a lippy as well. The lippy is from Juvia's Place in the shade Muted, which is a little bit more of a yellowy, browny, nudie color. Okay, falsies are the style Kylie from Primark that I don't know how long I can wear them for because they are getting old like me. Never mind. Let's finish off the face with, let's start with bronzer first. Let me just get the one that I love. It's just, to be honest, if this was the only bronzer that I had, I would not be sad about it. I'm very loyal to bronzers and such. Foundations as well. I found that I don't really like it if I have a lot of foundation. So there are just a few staple products that I don't know. Maybe I can do a video about that. My holy grails. Would you like that? Let me know down below. Okay, that is the bronzer. I don't want an overly bronzed face. Blush. Let me check. Because I think I don't know the highlighter that I want to use either. I had Galactic Purple. Oh, but it's so cool. But I had Galactic Purple already in the inner corner. So maybe I will use this one, the Blushing Pink. It's a little bit of a peachy one. Let's put it on first and then I will see for blush. That was what I wanted to say. Let's put it on first. It's nice. I was afraid that it was too light, but I think it's actually okay. Do I have a cast? I don't think so. I think it is a very subtle, the way that I'm using it right now, that is. But I do think that if you use a denser brush, the brush I have now is pretty fluffy, think that if you have a denser brush that you can really nicely make it blinding, because that's what happened basically in the inner corner. And I like to do highlighter before blush. I also like to bring it down a little, especially if the blush that I'm going to use is matte. I just like to do that, bring it down a bit. But because this is a peachier, I don't think it's necessarily, yeah, it is pink, but I don't know, almost on me, it can go either way. Does that make any sense at all? Maybe I'm rambling, I don't know. Let me find the blush. Let's go for orangey because I feel like it. So I have here the X Revolution blush in Cliché, which is a, I think it's a terracotta, I think. That way, yes. I like these. So basically then I'm just starting high and going down so that some of the highlighter is mixed in even more with the blush. I like that. I think this is cute. I feel cutesy. So yeah, here is the finished look. And I cannot wait to play with it more. Let me give you the first impression on the things that I have used. Yeah, I didn't use the pigments. Let's just go to the eyeshadow palette then, because that is the first thing that I used. I love the color story, hence the fact that I ordered it. When she actually showed the first time, this was more for, when she showed the revamped version the first time, it was more for the Black Friday boxes. But I'm so very happy that she made it permanent, because I think this is a very, very pretty color story. It's very, yes, it is a neutral color story, but still it is a little bit grungy. It's basically what is happening now, you know, those mustardy tones are very trendy, or at least I find them trendy. That basically means that I want to smear them all over my face. That is what trendy means for me, because I usually, I don't know. I really like this color story. I like the fact that you can go more towards the redder side with these browns. I like the fact, I love actually the fact that there is a gray in here, and that pairs so well with this more browny gray. And then these two are so similar. You can do very pretty monochromatic looks. So basically just put this one on your lid, or this one in the crease and this one on your lid. You can deepen it up with any of the browns if you want to, which I kind of did. You can keep it gray if you want to. You can go a little bit more pink and purple. You can go bronze. You can, I really like this one. I think that the shadows performed very well as well, which I thought they would, just feeling them. I really want to play with all the shades that are in here. So yeah, let's go then to the pigment. I have already used the purple pigment. I haven't used this one just yet, but as I said, it's a neon pigment, so usually it is placing and then a minimal amount of blending, otherwise it can go patchy and you can blend it away. I'm very curious to use this one though, and I'm also very curious to use it as a liner. It would probably actually go well with this shade, the mustardy. I don't know, but I'm very intrigued to pair it actually with the mustard. So, or with the gray. That would be nice as well. Okay, let's go next to the highlighters then. Yeah, the inner corner highlight. I love this type of combination. You know, that, I don't know, the bronzier one with then the purpley. I also love yellow and purple, so that's not really weird. It's pretty. I cannot wait to use it on my eyes or on my face. Will I use it on my face often? Probably not, but that does not matter, because I am very, very happy that I have finally the Galactic Purple, you know. And just, I don't know, do a color in the crease and then this on your lid would be very, very pretty as well. So yeah, I'm very happy that I have it. Then let's go to the pink one that I put on my face. Well, again, pink, it's called blushing pink, but for me it's almost maybe more of a peach. And I love that. I love a peach, because a lot of the time, if I have a colder pink, I love the color of that, but it is, a lot of the time it's too icy. And this, for me, I was afraid it would be too light, but it's not. It melts in very, very prettily. And I, again, love a shade like this. I can use this with a pink blush as well, but I also love the fact that it pairs so very well with an orangey blush. And I think this will be a gorgeous inner corner highlight as well. I think that you can make it blinding if you use, let me just do that, because why not? Let me get a denser highlighter brush. Come here. Thank you, dear. So let's see what we can do. Yeah, there she is. See that? There is definitely a highlighter for everyone in their range. So go check them out and go check them out anyway. I will leave their site down below. I will also list the makeup that I have on my face down below. Again, I did receive some of this in PR, but some of the other stuff I did pay for. And I cannot wait to play with it more. I feel pretty. Which is good. So now I'm going to film some other videos. I am going to film my December haul, which is surprisingly little. So yeah, and I think I'm also going to film then the November review. Or do I need to do the October review? I don't know. Let me check. And I'm going to film those videos as well, so that I can make use of the prettiness that is me today. Yes. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Let me go to the side to give a special thank you to my members. Oh, and remove the hair from my nose that you will see scrolling on the screen, not the hair, the members. Yes, if you want to become a member, there is a link to join in the description box. There's also a link to the merch shop in case you are interested. So yeah, guys, let me know what you thought of the video. Let me know what you thought of some of the ideas that I kind of spewed out. And if you have video ideas, feel free to leave them down in the comment section. This is it for me today. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. Mine kinda does. But if I put a sweater that's a little bit higher, no one will notice. So yeah. Have an amazing day. Bye, guys.